really good looking guy too. So how you doing? I'm Dwayne and this is Joe.
Hi everybody, welcome.
And we've got a great show for you guys tonight. We're going to give you a little bit of a rundown of how it's going to go, because I know I like a little bit of a plan, right? So the program order tonight goes as follows. Act one is 5 performances. Then we're going to have an intermission. Then we'll have special words from the president of the Bucks County Chamber, Dr. Vale Garvin. Then act two, another 5 performances. Then a special closing act by Elvis Pretzel. And then we'll announce the winners, okay? So that's how it's gonna go tonight for all the judges and everybody here. Now, we also like to take this time to thank the New Hope Winery, which is, right? A nicer place to spend an evening, and we want to extend our thanks to Sandra Price and Desiree Rosner over there, and the event center at New Hope Winery, and of course, Mike Lightkep over here for taking care of our lights and sound.
Good evening, everybody. It's a big honor to be here for 3 years in a row. We're so happy to see talented people and support them, and please enjoy this extravaganza show, and good luck, everyone.
Wow, I'm in front of the microphone again this year. I promise I will not sing. Welcome to a great evening. Happy birthday, Brad. Because I've been involved in the chamber enough, it's all about Brad. But CNN, we're your community bank here in the Central Bucks area. We love sponsoring community events. This is our bread and butter. We'd love all of you to bank with us, but notwithstanding that, enjoy the show. Great seeing people down Mass. There's more people than there was last year, so great job to the Chamber, and love this New Hope Winery venue, so enjoy the evening.
All right, thank you, Zach.
Thank you.
got beginner's luck. The first time that I'm in love with you. Gosh, I'm lucky. I've got beginner's luck. There never was such a smile or such eyes of blue. Gosh, I'm fortunate. This thing we've begun is much more than a pastime. For this time is the one where the first time is the last time. I've got beginner's luck, lucky through and through. For the first time that I'm in love with you.
Tears stop flowing from your face after hours of crying, because when you're not here, my heart breaks. Thinking about the things I never got to say. All the times and the memories that'll soon be wiped from my memory. The journey to heal is black and ugly, and when I look back on the memories that I have, they're all dull and gray. Because how can anything be filled with color when the loss of you is so severe? Every time I look around, I see you in everything. I remember how you used to laugh, how you used to sing. I'm like a piece of a puzzle or a bird with broken wings. I'm simply incomplete. There's something missing without you here, holding me in your arms and no longer safe. But I will walk this journey to heal every day until I start to feel what won't happen in a month or even a year. But I will not fear, because I know deep down you're still here, still watching, giving me your earnest smile, telling me it's okay and to talk for a while. Time seems to stop when you're going through grief, but remembering the good times that we had, it's put my world on replay. I will never forget the day that you went away. Your final breath, the smell of the hospital, or the scratchy bed, the intense pain. But I'll get better to cope with it every day. I knew you would have wanted it this way. I hate that you're gone, but I'm glad that I've got the time to spend with you. I will love you forever and always. Thank you.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo.
Don't cry. It's only a knock, knock joke. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
eat for dinner?
What?
Hamburgers.
The simple words I try to say. I only live to love you more each day. More than you'll ever know, my arms long to hold you, so my life will be in your keeping, waking, sleeping, laughing, weeping. Longer than always is a long, long time, but far beyond forever, you'll be mine.
Worry man, to sing the worries on my worry now. Bucks County. Give it up for yourselves for coming out for live entertainment. It has been a long couple of years, but you all are what makes it go, so thank you so, so much for coming out and supporting some wonderful, wonderful artists. So welcome to the dad bod portion of the evening. It's just going to be me and Mumford & Sons for the next 3 hours, so sit tight. We're just going to rock and roll. Hope you guys are settling in real nice. In case you can't tell by the size of the nose and the hair and the poor judgment when it comes to buttoning shirts, I am Italian. Any Italians in here?
Yes.
Yeah, all right. Oh, wow. Yeah, I'm like the friggin' love child of Robert De Niro and Toucan Sam. I've been dealing with that, walking through life like, yo, good, yo, eh? Follow your nose, it always knows that. Look at that, come on. I basically spend my life like kind of suspended between a laugh and a cry, always looking like I have to sneeze, like, goes with that. So yeah, I was born with this face. I got a lot of Italians in here. You know, one thing I can't stand about being Italian is how many people associate Italians with those Jersey Shore Guidos. Clap if you watch that trash any time in your life. You're all liars. It's like the number one rated show in the history of television. They have like millions of reruns of that show, and now they have like new seasons and reunions. And I can't stand that show is what I used to say every Thursday night when my wife and I would tune in to watch it. And the one thing I can't stand about how people associate Italians with those Jersey Shore Guidos is those being a Guido has absolutely nothing to do with being Italian. In fact, some of the best Guidos I know are actually Armenian. Bro. Bro. Growing up in Thailand was tough. It was weird. We had a lot of weird superstitions and absolutely had no idea why we had them. So I remember I'd just be sitting at the table like, oh man, I don't feel so good. My grandmother would chime in like, hey, you're taking a potato! What? You're taking a potato, you're slicing a potato. You're taking a slice of a potato, you're putting a hand, you tie a handkerchief, and there you go. Why would I do that, Grandma? Hey, you got a headache, no? No, I have strep throat. Hey, you're taking a potato, you put your throat, it's the same thing. My grandmother was Joe Pesci. Like, Grandma, what if I hurt my elbow? I take it a potato. Hey, don't be a stoop. Use the peppercorn. She does like a backflip out of the room. She looked to be 100. She's like a remedy ninja. God bless her. I always wonder where that came from, though. Where did that originate, those superstitions? I just imagine, like, Giuseppe in the hills of Italy, like, returning to the town. He goes and visits, like, the sick elderly woman in the town. He's like, I have the book, the cure. I go to the medical school, I have the cure. And the cure for the woman is, and then my grandmother just kicks up, that's the potato! My mother's a little nuts with this stuff too. She hasn't been to the doctor since the 80s. The 80s, the 1980s. That's insane. That is literally insane. I was like, Mom, what are you doing? You don't go to the doctor? How do you not go to the doctor? She's like, yeah, you're in Alba. Totally healthy. Went to the doctor. Cancer. It's airtight logic. I mean, it's a foolproof defense. I should have been a lawyer. No, you shouldn't. My lawyers go to the doctor. And they sue for malpractice. Any parents here tonight? Any parents? Yeah? Sound freaking exhausted. So I know you're not lying. I am a dad. I have three beautiful children, 8, 5, and 3, I think, that's what they tell me. After the first one, it's all just, isn't that so sad? Like, after the first one, you just kind of, like, gets watered down. It's just like, the first one, you're like, oh my God, how are you feeling? How are your emotions? Like, the third one, it's just like, hey, bud, you get something to eat today? Here, try this pizza NFT I just bought. See if that does it for you. Yeah, on your roll, brother. What is he? That kid's like 12, right? Exactly. Probably has a lot of NFTs. But I am a dad of three, and the one thing that I gotta tell you all is I have been changing diapers for 8 consecutive years. Clap for me. Clap for that. 8 consecutive years changing diapers. I am a poop sommelier. Experienced in all the varietals, from the earthy tones of Le mac and cheese of Provence to the barrel oak aged chicken McNugget of McDonald's. Let me tell you something. You have not lived until you have come face to face with the final poop particle on your baby boy's crusted ball sack. He's just staring at you, mocking you, laughing at you. You just slowly reach for the wipe, bring it in slow, roll it, make a nice jagged edge, and bring it in nice and slow. Not too slow though, you don't want to scare it off, but not too fast, because you don't want to knock it off the cliff. You get in there, you get that thing, you raise it up like the Super Bowl trophy, right? And you look at it like, yeah, I did it, I took care of my boy, like I did it, boy. And he looks back at you like, you did it, Dad. And you're just overcome with this warm emotion, right? Because you know you took care of your boy. And it's at that moment you realize your son just pissed all over you. Because he took too long to change the freaking diaper. Thank you all so much for your time. I'm Steve DiNardo. Have a great evening.
The worst things I could do than go with a boy or two. them when we dance. Make them think they stand a chance. Then refuse to see it through. That's a thing I'd never do.
in the land of high. Old times are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Sing it, fellas. You know your daddy.